Birmingham-based Real Estate Investors has confirmed the acquisition of investment properties in Wolverhampton and Coventry for £7.125 million in cash, producing rental income of some £730,000 per year at a net initial yield of 9.8%. CEO Paul Bassi joins me now. Hello there, Paul. Tell me a little bit more about the deal. What exactly have you bought and who are your tenants?
Okay, first of all, it's very consistent with what we buy. We have a very strict criteria of sticking to the West Midlands, and we look to buy assets that we can add further value to. So these have been no different. So we've bought a large retail unit in Wolverhampton Town Centre. The vendor that owned the property before us, in fact, paid £5.4 million and we paid £2 million. And we bought this from the Irish National Asset Management Agency. That's where all the distressed bank stocks have been sitting for the last few years. Very pleased with that one. Bought off an initial yield of 13%. There's a short lease with a renewal in March next year. I expect the rental income to come down because it's slightly over-rented, but nevertheless, it's a great acquisition, arguably the best retail unit in the city centre of Wolverhampton. Coventry, again, more of the same. Offices on this occasion on a very well-known park in Coventry with some great occupiers that have been there for a long time. And we've also managed to buy some land in that I think we can get further development potential on. So more of the same, and clearly all this fresh income goes towards our dividend pot, and we're very keen to continue growing that.
Now, you must be nearing your £200 million portfolio target now. I mean, how does this all fit into the overall strategy and enhance the portfolio?
Yeah. We're not, if this was a tortoise and hare race, we're very much the tortoise. So we're quietly getting to where we need to get to. We're still on track to get to the 200 million mark at the end of the first quarter. And hopefully by the time we announce our full year results, we'll have got there.
And in terms of revenue growth, what is this deal going to add going forward?
Well, I suspect that our revenue growth is now in the region, our total contracted rental income is in the region of about £12 million per annum, allowing for these investment purchases. That's some considerable increase on where we were this time last year. And I expect that to grow over the year to in excess of 15 during 2016.
Now, you mentioned that you're looking to the first quarter in 2016. It's been a busy year. Have you finished the shopping spree, or can we expect more of the same as 2016?
I finished the shopping spree for 2015, but I tend not to use the word shopping spree. We're very much serious investors, and market opportunities have allowed us to buy assets, as I've just said. The Wolverhampton building was previously bought for £5.4 million, and I could give you similar stories throughout our portfolio. So we'll buy when the opportunity is right, and we've got enough of a pipeline for me to tell you that we'll be north of £200 million next year with an income stream in excess of £15
million. Now, you had that fundraise in April, didn't you, for £45 million?
We did, yeah.
So have you got enough then to spend to reach those targets? You mentioned it's slow but steady. When are you going to have to start being careful with the pennies?
Well, we're always careful with the pennies, first of all. We raised that money because we had the pipeline of opportunities. So we raised £45 million. In fact, throughout the year, we spent in excess of £65 million. And we're not at all short of capital because we bought all these properties from cash. We are in the process of re-gearing a new bank facility against all of our unencumbered assets. So when we get out of bed in January, we hope to have something in the region of £30 to £35 million available for further purchases.
So a lot to play with then. What next though, and when? You mentioned towards the middle to the end of January there might be some news. Is that the next milestone?
Yeah, we've already got a number of things that are in legals. They just simply won't get wrapped up over between now and Christmas due to holidays. These are deals agreed in legals. They will come through in the first quarter of next year. But the thing that I'm most pleased about is our vision on our dividend. We can see our income. We can see our dividend growing. And I'm fairly sure we'll be beating market expectations.
Well, investors will like the sound of that. Look, I look forward to hearing about those new deals once you've got through all of the legal wranglings there. have a great Christmas and New Year, and speak to you in 2016.
Great. See you soon.
Thanks, Paul.
Okay. Bye.